Hello students, standard 10 chapter number 1 real numbers. Today we discuss about the proof of the irrational number, right? So in a proof of irrational number, then we have to first of all discuss the theorem 1.3. Theorem 1.3. So that theorem first of all I write here, then after we will discuss that. So let the P be a prime number. P be a prime number. Be a prime number, and that prime number divides a square. Divides a square. Then P divides A. Then P divides A, where A is a positive integer. Where A is a positive integer. And this A, which we represent here, is a positive integer. Now we define that. What is that thing? P be a prime number. We already discussed in our previous period. Prime numbers. Prime numbers what? Prime numbers means what? The numbers who has only two factor, which is a 1 and number itself. Right? So that type of prime number is what? 2, 3, 5, 7, 11, 13, 17. These all are number is a prime numbers. So P be a prime number. So any one of the prime number we have to take, and that prime number divides the S square. That prime number divides the S square. Then you can also say that P, that prime number is divide A. Where A is what? Positive integer. Positive integer means what? Integer we are now in integer, negative numbers, 0 and positive numbers we have to include. But they mention A value is what? Positive integer only. So we have to consider from the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 up to infinite. Right? So positive integer we have to take as a A. So that theorem we will discuss with one example. Suppose I take, one number A is equal to 4. Suppose I take that A is equal to 4. And 4 is a positive integer, right? A is a positive integer, A is equal to 4. Now that theorem is what? That 4 means A is square. A square. So 4 square is what? 16 is there. 4 square is what? 16. So that 16 is divided by any prime number. Any prime number. Then you can say that 4 is also divided by that prime number. Right? Suppose I take the prime number as a 2. Prime number as a 2 I take in this example. Then as per that theorem, here we can say theorem, as per the theorem 1.3, 2 we take as a prime number. So 2 as a prime number, 2 as a prime number, and that 2 divided by a square. So it means 16 divided by 2. It is possible, right? If 16 divided by 2, because a square means what? You can say 4 square is divided by 2, and it is possible. 4 square is always divided by 2. Then you can say also that 4 is also, that A is also divided by the prime number, that 4 is also divided by 2. 4 is also divided by 2 is possible. Okay. So this is our theorem 1.3. So remember that thing. P divided by A square, then P divides A. Okay. Now based on that, we have to prove the irrationality of the numbers. So suppose here in our textbook, that theorem 1.4, which is given, prove root 2 is an irrational number. We have to prove, this is given, theorem 1.4, root 2 is an irrational number. Now all of you, I hope all of you know that real numbers, in this real number, there are rational number and irrational number. Right? Two types of number in a real number, rational number and irrational number. For proving the irrationality, what we have to do? Whatever the number here, we first of all assume that it is a rational number. So first we assume root 2 is a rational number. And then after we prove that, this is our wrong prediction. Whatever we assume, this is our wrong prediction. So it is ultimately become a irrational number, right? Because if any number it is not a rational number, then it is become a irrational number. So that way we have to prove the irrationality. Okay. So first of all, in a solution, as I told you, let assume whatever the number is a rational number. As I told you, you have to take the given number as a rational. And we all are known the rational number, how we can write. Root 2 is equal to, suppose I take the rational number as a by b, where a and b both are integer, and you cannot take the b as an integer. A and b both are integer, and you cannot take b as a zero, right? So b is not equal to zero. Another thing, a and b both are co-prime number. Co-prime number means what? The numbers having only one common vector, which is a 1. Suppose I give the one of the example, 10 by 15 is there. 10 by 15, which is a rational number, right? So here we can say 2 5s are, and this is a 3 5. 5 5s cancel out, right? So we get the 2 by 3. So here 2 by 3 is also a rational number. Observe, a and b, a is equal to 2, b is equal to 3. That two numbers having the only one common factor, which is what? Which is a 1. No any another common factor. So the number we have a only one common factor, which is a 1, it is called the co-prime number. So a and b, we have to take a and b are co-prime number, and as I told you, denominator we cannot take as a 0. B is not equal to 0. Okay, so we assume first of all root 2 is a rational number, which we represent root 2 is equal to a by b. Now we take the squaring on both sides. So what we get? So here we get the root 2 square, and in the right hand side we get the a by b all square. So we get the root 2 square is what? 2 only, and a square by b square. Right? Now that b square is comes to the left hand side, and 2 goes to the right hand side in denominator. So it is what? B square is equal to a square by 2. Right? So here you can also write another thing. B square is goes to the here. So 2 b square is equal to a square. We have to give the equation number 1. 2 b square is equal to a square. And suppose the 2 is goes to the right hand side. So we can write b square is equal to a square by 2. Now observe that thing. That thing we discussed in our theorem 1.3. What? Here that 2 is divide the a square. 2 is divide the a square. And we can say 2 is also divide the a. That thing we already discussed in theorem 1.3. So here we can say, so 2 divides a square, and we can say 2 divide a from theorem 1.3. This is our second equation. Okay. Now, what is the meaning of that 2 divides a square? If 2 divides a, 2 divides a square, and then we define 2 divides a. So it means if you divide a divide by 2, then you get the c, which is any integer. C is any integer, right? Any number is divisible by another number, then you get the any number as an answer, right? So now if these 2 is multiplied in the right hand side, so a is equal to 2c. Okay. Now we take the squaring on both the side. So we get the left hand side a square. Here is a 2c square. Squaring on both sides. So we get this one. So it means what? A square is equal to 4c square. Now that a square value we put in equation number 1. Right? So on putting a square value in equation 1. So here in equation 1, left hand side is a 2b square, and right hand side is square. A square value we have to put 4c square. That 2 is goes to the right hand side in denominator. So 4c square divided by 2. So we get the b square is equal to 2 to the 4. So 2c square. That 2 is goes to the left hand side in denominator. So b square divided by 2 is equal to c square. Now what is the meaning of that from the theorem 1.3? Here we can say 2 is a prime number, which is divide the b square. 2 divides b square, and we can say 2 is divide b. the equation number 3, right? Now observe the, from equation number 2 and equation number 3, which thing we can conclude? In equation number 2, there we define the 2 divides A, and equation number 3, there we define the 2 divides B. So we can say A and B having the 2 as a common factor, right? 2 divides A and 2 divides B. It means A and B having a 2 as a common factor, right? So from equation 2 and 3, equation 2 and equation 3, we can say A and B have 2 as a common factor. A and B have a 2 as a common factor. But here we already defined A and B are what? Co-prime number. And there we learn whenever the co-prime numbers, then it has a only one common factor, which is a 1. But here we define A and B have a 2 as a common factor. Right? So this is a contradict the fact. Okay? So but this is a contradict the fact. This is a contradict the fact that A and B have no common factor other than one. This is a contradict the fact. Whenever we assume, then we define A and B have only one factor, common factor, which is a 1. But here, after doing that, we get A and B have a 2 as a common factor. Right? So, this is a contradict the fact. A and B have a no common factor other than a 1. So, that is a contradict occur due to the our wrong assumption. Because we assume that root 2 is a rational number, right? So, we define that contradiction occur, that contradiction arise due to our wrong assumption as root 2 is a rational number. That we assume that root 2 is a rational number. So what we conclude? So we conclude that if it is a due to a wrong assumption, root 2 is a rational number. So what we conclude? It is not a rational number. It is a root 2 is an irrational number. Irrational number. Okay. So that way you can prove the any numbers irrationality that we can define this way. Okay. This is very simple. How we have to define whatever the number we have to take. First of all, we have to assume a rational number. In that rational number, whatever the numerator and denominator, we have to take as a co-prime number. It means it has a only one common factor, which is a 1, and denominator never be 0. After that, what you have to remember, then if we define A and B are co-prime number, then as I told you, we have to prove that this is not a rational number, our assumption is wrong. Then you have to, one target in your mind, A has a common factor other than 1, and B has a common factor other than 1. So that's why here we define, first of all we take the square and then we define 2 divides by A. So it means A has a one of the factor, which is a 2. And after that, A is divided by 2, so we get another integer. Then after we have to rearrange and square out both 1, whatever S square value we have to put in equation number 1. And after that we have to define the 2 divides B. So that we can define A and B having the 2 as a common factor, right? But this is a contradict the fact that A and B have a no common factor other than 1. So our assumption, which is a wrong, right? So due to that, we can say root 2 is an irrational number. Now, in exercise 1.3, there is given, prove the root 5 is an irrational number. In exercise 1.3, they give question number 1 is a prove root 5 is an irrational number. Prove root 5 is an irrational number. So what you have to do? Same way you have to follow all these steps. So first of all, here you have to write, assume root 5 is an is a rational number. Then you have to define root 5 is equal to in form of rational number a by b, where a and b are co-prime number and b means denominator is not equal to 0. If you take the squaring on both the side, so you get the root 5 square is equal to a square by b square. So we get the phi is equal to a square by b square. It means what? That b square is multiplied here. So we get a square is equal to phi b square. Equation number 1. Right? Now that phi is going to the left hand side. So we get the a square by phi is equal to b square. So from this step what we can write? That phi is divided a square. And see, as per the theorem, if phi divides, phi is a prime number is divide a square, then you can say phi is also divide a from the theorem 1.3. Give the equation number 2. Now, as I told, if phi, which is a prime number, divide the a, then you get the any another integer which is a c. C is any integer, right? So here we get the a is equal to phi c, phi into c. So now squaring on both the sides. So left hand side is a square, right hand side phi into c square. So we get the a square is equal to 25 into c square. Right? Now that a square value we put in equation number 1. So in equation number 1, then we define 25 c square. Here a square value we put here. So 25 into c square is equal to 5 into b square. Right? Here a square value we have put 25 c square. Now then that 25 goes to the right hand side. So we get the 5 into b square divided by 25. So we get the c square is equal to 5 is 25. So b square by 5. So that means what? That b square is divided by 5. Means phi is divided b. We can say phi, which is a prime number, divides b square. So as per the theorem 1.3, what we can say? Phi divides b. So from the equation number 2 and equation number 3, phi divides a and phi divides b. Now what we can put? A and b have a phi as a common factor. And this is, but this is a contradict the fact. A and b have a co-prime number here we define. So it is a contradiction of fact that a and b have no common factor other than 1. So that contradiction arises due to our wrong assumption as root 5 is a rational number. Right? So it is not a rational number. It means what? We can put what? Root 5 is an irrational number. Okay? So that way we can prove the any numbers irrationality. Many other such are possible. Maybe ask, prove the root 7 is a irrational number, root 11 is a irrational number, root 13 is a irrational number. All the irrational numbers prove, you have to define that way only. Okay? So it is very easy and most probably asked in an examination for the 3 marks. Okay? And it may be asked for the students, chapter number 1, real number. Exercise 1.3, question number 2 we have to solve today. Question number 2 and 3. Question number 2, there is given prove that 3 plus 2 root 5 is an irrational number. So in our previous period, there we define the irrationality, how we can prove. Okay? So whatever the numbers we have to prove irrational, then first of all we have to take as a rational number. So we assume here the 3 plus 2 root 5 is a rational number. We have to assume the 3 plus 2 root 5 is a rational number. We all know how we can represent the rational number. 3 plus 2 root 5 is equal to, rational number is defined by numerator upon denominator. So here I take as a as a numerator, b as a denominator, where a and b are co-prime number, as we defined in our previous period. Co-prime number means what? The number we have which has a only one common factor, which is a 1. And denominator we have not take as a 0. B is not equal to 0. Okay. So this is a rational number. Now we have to prove this is a irrational number. This number is an irrational number. So for that, what we have to do? Here plus 3 we have to take in the right hand side. So this become a minus 3. A by b minus 3. And root 5 is multiplied with the 2, so that 2 is goes to the right hand side. So in both the terms, having the denominator which is multiplied by 2, so minus 3 by 2. A by 2b minus 3 by 2. That 2 is goes to the right hand side. So both term I will get a 2 as a denominator. Right? So here is a b is already there, so it is multiplied with 2, and here is a denominator we get as a 2. Otherwise you can define that way. So here root 5 and that 2 is goes to the right hand side. So it is a denominator. A by b minus 3. Now that 1 by 2 is multiplied inside. So you get the root 5 is equal to, it is multiplied with first term, so a by 2b, and 1 by 2 is multiplied with minus 3, so minus 3 by 2. Now observe here, a by b is a rational number and denominator is multiplied with 2, so that a by 2b is a rational number only. Here a by 2b is a rational number, and that rational number 3 by 2 is also rational number. So substitution of rational number by rational number, we get a rational number only. So we can define a by 2b minus 3 by 2 is also a rational number. So right hand side total is a rational number. So is equal sign is there. So what we can say? Root 5 is also a rational number. So from this one we can say, so root 5 is a rational number. Root 5 is a rational number. But we all are known, root 5 is what? It is a irrational number. So what we can say? This is a part, this is a contradict the fact. This is a contradict the fact. Which fact? Root 5 is an irrational number. Irrational number. So this statement's contradiction is here. Root 5 is a rational number. So here we can say it is a contradict the fact. Root 5 is a irrational number. So we can say this contradiction arises due to wrong assumption as we assume that 3 plus 2 root 5 is a rational number. A wrong assumption. So we conclude that 3 plus 2 root 5 is an irrational number. Okay? Irrational number. So that way we can define the irrationality. Same way, prove that the following numbers are irrational. 3 questions is given. Right now we can solve the two questions. The third one you have to solve similarly. Okay? So first question, same way we have to define that numbers group. Let's assume 1 by root 2 is a rational number. And we all are now rational number, how we can define 1 by root 2 is equal to a by b, where I given the condition a and b are what? Co-prime number. And you cannot take the denominator as a, here we have to not take a b as a 0, right? So now here is a in 1 by root 2, here is a by b. Root 2 is a irrational in denominator, so we have to rationalize it. So for that we have to multiply and divide by the root 2, right? Rationalize the denominator. So root 2 into root 2 in denominator we get the 2 only, because this is the root 2 square. In numerator 1 into root 2 we get the root 2 is equal to a by b. So the 2 is multiplied right hand side with numerator, so root 2 is equal to 2a by b. Now a by b is a rational, so 2a by b is also a rational number. So here 2a by b is a rational number. So that number is equal with this one. So we can say we get here root 2 is a rational number. Root 2 is a rational number. Right? But we know that root 2 is what? Is a irrational number, right? So we can say, but this is a contradict the fact that integration of number. So this contradiction arisen due to our wrong assumption. As 1 by root 2 is a rational number. So we can say 1 by root 2 is what? We conclude that 1 by root 2 is an irrational number. So that way we can define the any numbers with irrationality. Same way, second question which is given 7 root 5, we have to prove it is an irrational number. So first of all we have to assume 7 root 5 is a rational number. Now if you assume that, so 7 root 5 you can represent by A by B, where A and B are co-prime number and B you cannot take as a 0, right? Now 7 is goes to the right hand side in denominator, so in left hand side we get the root 5 only. So here we define A by 7 into B. A by 7 into B is what? It is a rational number only. And then A by 7 B is a rational, which is equal with this one. So we can say root 5 is a rational number. But we know that root 5 is whatever number, it is a irrational number. So we can say, but this is a contradict the fact that root 5 is an irrational number. So we can say this contradiction arisen due to our wrong assumption as 7 root 5 is a rational number. So what we can conclude? We conclude that 7 root 5 is which type of number? 7 root 5 is an irrational number. Okay. So then similarly you can solve the 6 plus root 2 is an irrational number. So that way you can define the irrationality for any number.